et pauper sum ego.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, be with you. Welcome, my brethren. We are celebrating this Eucharist on the third Sunday of Lent. And so, to celebrate with joy the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to my God, to my brothers and sisters, that I have prayed this day in my heart of sacrifice, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, from my
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison.
That we who are bowed down by our conscience may always be lifted up by your mercy. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Of the Egyptians and bring them up out of the
that the slave I see walk these many years. What am I to tell them? And God said to Moses, I am who I am. This, he added, is what you must say to the sons of Israel. The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name for all time. By this name I shall be invoked for all generations to come. Thanks be to the Lord of the Lord. The response for the song is, the Lord is compassion and love.
The Lord is compassion and love.
My soul gives thanks to the Lord, and my mind blesses all men. My soul gives thanks to the Lord, and never forget all his blessings. It is healing for the soul in our world, who heals every one of your enemies, who redeems your life from the grave, who crowns you with love and compassion. The Lord does give the of justice, gives judgment for all who are oppressed. He made known his ways to Moses, and his deeds to all Israel our sons. The Lord is compassionate and love, slow to work to anger and rich in mercy. For all the heavens are high above the earth, so strong is his love for those who fear him. The second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. I want to remind you, brothers, how our fathers were all guided by a cloud above them, and how they all passed through the sea. They were all baptized in Moses. In this cloud and in this sea, all had the same spiritual food, and all drank the same spiritual drink. Since then, all drank from all the spirit of God to the fall of them and as they did. All that God was Christ. In spite of this, most of them failed to please God, and their hearts withered to death. This seems to happen as warnings for us, not to have to be lust for forbidden sins that they had. You must never complain, some of them did, and they were killed by the destroyer. All this happened to them as a warning, and it was written down to be a lesson for those who are living at the end of the age. The man who seems to be safe must be very careful that he does not fall. Word of the Lord.
Yes.
Please stand up for the gospel of the Lord. God, we hope Christ, you are the word of God.
They were not, I tell you. No, but unless you
crowned and anointed. It may bear fruit next year. If not, then we can cut it down. The Gospel of the Lord.
I believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God,
salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For when he asked the Samaritan woman for water to drink, he had already created the gift of faith within her, and so ardently did he thirst for her faith, that he kindled in her the fire of divine love. And so we too give you thanks with the angels and saints. Praise your mighty deeds as we play singing.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis sunt celi et terra, gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore this gift, we pray, by sending on your Spirit upon the heart of your Father, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered, kneeling in his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith we proclaim in the name of the profess resurrection until the coming of man. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly pray that the partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and the valor bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit the equal page to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, and full by the divine teaching, we are there to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to suffer on the Lamb.
Et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Tantum ergo sacramentum veneremur senui, et anticum documentum novos sedat ris. tus honor virtus quoque, sit et benedictio procedenti ab utroque. Comparsit laudatio.
As we receive the flesh of things yet hidden in heaven, and are nourished while still on earth with the bread that comes from high, from on high, we humbly entreat you, O Lord, that what is being brought about in us in mystery may come to true completion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So we shall keep what we heard in the Gospel today, and remembering also that sometimes when God believes that some situations that are not so good in our lives happen, it's not because He doesn't love us. It's not because of that. It's because as children of God that we are, so often we say to our Father that He is a Father. Sometimes we have to fall on the ground to understand and to that it's necessary to grow up as persons, as sons and daughters of God, and of course as human beings. So God is a Father. There is no father or mother that will forget their own children. Okay? So we shall take that in our hearts. And I think there is nothing else to say. No. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And we should do it again. Go with peace, the Mass is ended.
Ave Regina Celorum, Ave Domina Angelorum. Salve radis, salve porta, eis qua mundo luces torta, gaude Virgo gloriosa, super omnes speciosa, vale, o valde decora, et pro nobis.